everybody. I'm your host of the night, your personal assistant nurse, Maxis. My previous owner called me Anvi. With A, no, not the E. And today, I'm gonna tell you a story. A story about the tall man. This is a request from my previous owner that ordered me to do this. So let's get into the story. I knew of an old Romanian fighter, highly unpopular even. It is easy deterrence. It might be based on a particular event, or perhaps is an exploration from existing sediment story. The translation I'm most familiar with goes a bit like this. So we start with a description. Sorry, my jukebox is really damaged. Once upon a time, there were three twin girls, Stella and Sorina. They were brave little girls and have no fear of dark, nor spiders and other crawling things. Well, I guess they are brave. When other young ladies and even young boys showed cowards, Stella and Sorina luck with their heads on. They were good girls, obedient to their mother and father, and to the word of God. They were the best children a mother could ask for, and this was their undoing, Alphonse. I wonder why. One day, the twins were out with their mother gathering berries from the forest. They might bring them stay close to her and they listen, as they were good children. The way the day was bright and clear, even as they walked closer to the center of the forest, the light very dimmed. It was nearly bright as noon when they found the tall man. Oh, already in the picture? The tall man stood in the clean dress as a noble, all in black. Shadows lay over him, dark as a cloud midnight. He has many arms, all long and boneless as snakes, all sharp as swords, and they written like warm nails. He did not speak, but made it intentions known. Says not by head, yes or no. I don't see that logical. The man tried not to listen, but she could not more disobey the torment that she forget how to breathe. She walked into the clearing. Her daughter saw it with her. Stella, she said, take my knife and cut a sack on the ground big enough to lie in. Stella, who was not afraid of the tall man, nor afraid of the quiver in her mother's voice, obedient what her mother say, Sorina, the mother said, take the base and spread them in the circle and crush them underfoot until the juice stained the earth. To Sorina, wondering why her mother asked her to do such a thing, she obedient because she was a good girl. Okay, I guess they are good girls. You don't have to tell that every paragraph. Stare, the mother said. Lie in the circle. Stare to her. Why she might stay her clothes. Did as her mother asked. Sorina, the mother said, and bind Sorina, cut her sister open with the knife. Wait, what? She cut her sister? Sorina could not, should not. Please, her mother said, if you don't, if I will be worse, so much worse. Well, but Sorina could not, and she threw the knife away and ran home crying. She hid under her bed, afraid for the first time in her life. Well, is there a place for anything new? She waited until her father came from the field and told him of the terrible things she had found in the woods. Her father confessed her and told her she should be safe. He went to the woods, his axe in hand, and as the commanded, she stayed by the hut, waiting for his return. After some time, she fell asleep. When she awoke, it was the sound of knocking on the door. At the darkest hour of the night. Who is there? She said. It is your father, the knocker said. I don't believe you, said Sorina. It is your sister, the knocker said. I cannot be, said Sorina. I am your mother, said the knocker. And I told you it should be yours, and the door locked tight before her father left, felt open as he had let a zar, and her mother stepped in, her sister's head chucked in one bloody hand, her father in the other. Whoa. Why, wept Soina? Because, say her mother, there is no reward for goodness, there is no spice for faith, there is nothing but cold steel, teeth, and soaking fire of all of us. It's coming for you now. Who, I wonder? And the tall man slides from the fire and cleans Serena in his burning embers. And that was the end of her. Well, this was a story. I don't know why my previous owner want me to read this and actually make this a tradition if this work. But hope you enjoyed this video. The new owner is supposed to come next month or two. And yeah, hope you enjoyed this and see you in the... Who is knocking the door? I don't expect any visitors.